All right, today I want to talk about an amazing tool that we used to really run the beating heart of our business. This is a collaboration, task management, project management tool called Podio. There's plenty of them out there. This one I really liked because it has a great way of reporting on the completion of projects that we can screenshot and send to our clients really easily. So they're going to tell you a whole mess of interesting sales stuff on this homepage and who knows what other features they've got going on. We're going to skip right into the middle of doing this thing, but before I do, let's have a look at the pricing because this is one of the things I really liked. Certainly they have a bunch of plans they want you to buy, your basic, your plus, your premium. Those might change over time. But if you're not sure and you just want to check it out, make sure you scroll down and do this try Podio free option, which is what we're going to do right now. So we're going to set up a test account. My typing is fairly appalling there. A test account, which we'll just put my name on it and we'll figure out a password. What's a neat password? We'll figure out a password here. Wow. Really doesn't like my password. There we go. That's a better one. And we will go ahead and sign up. And it's going to send me an email. So let me just sneak off. We'll grab that email and I'm going to hit confirm. And then it's going to log us right in. Okay. And I'm back. Once I hit confirm, it asks me to do a whole mess of interesting stuff. Goodness gracious. What kind of company are we? I guess we'll put ourselves down as marketing. How do I intend to use this? Task management for sure. And phone number, well, you know what? We're going to skip that one. And what it does is it brings us, to all this training. We're going to skip all of that. We're going to skip all of that. Skip all of that. Eventually, it brings you to this page here. And it's trying to give me some help over here on the right-hand side, telling me how to do things. I'm going to just whip past all of that, requesting a call to talk to someone. I'm going to whip past all of that and just do my own thing. Okay, so what is Podio all about? The basic unit of Podio is a task. And if I click on T, it allows me to create a new task. Every task has the detail of the task. That's this top piece here. Who is actually doing the task? And you can see my name because I'm the only guy enrolled in this thing so far. What the due date is and a time of that day if you want. And this is the really important one. What project or workspace it's going to be associated with. And there's nothing there right now, so it's just associating it with the empty idea of projects, and you can put in more details, attach files, labels, and so on. Tasks are everything, and they're grouped by projects, which you can see up here, or deliverables. Now, you can hit this button here that says Add App, and you can go to the app market and find huge numbers of free apps that you can actually install, but I urge you to not get too excited about that, because really all they are is different wrapping on the same basic idea of grouping tasks. So I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna come back to clicking on Podio. Now, when you click on Podio, what it does is it gives you this kind of play-by-play page, which is designed to summarize everything. So this is the activity stream, what everyone's been up to. Right now, it's done all of these things for me. It's joined me to all these groups and done all this kind of beginning stuff. But normally, it's got stuff like who's doing what task and when and how it's going. Over here are projects. There aren't any, but it would normally list them. Over here is everyone who's in the system, which right now is just me because I'm the only one there, and favorite apps and so on. And this whole thing is configurable, and that's excellent because you're going to want to change that around. But let's start off by with this idea of workspaces. So again, tasks are the essential item grouped in projects, grouped in workspaces. So if I click on this workspace thing, it's set up some automatic ones for me, but I'm just going to go ahead and start one from scratch to give the idea. And I'm going to call it My Projects, and I'm going to make it open, which means that everybody who is in my network can actually see it. As soon as I create a project, it wants to know who is in it. So for example, I might put myself in it, which makes sense, or I might invite my assistant, Andrea, to it as well. There she is. Hi. And she might become part of this too. And it goes ahead and sends out an email to all of those people. It's even wanting to get more of them. But again, I'm in the free version, so I want to kind of keep that to under 5 people for now. If I want to invite more people, I can click on invite from the workspace. Now, right now, all I've got in this workspace is kind of, well, nothing. I've got this activity app, which just shows me this stuff. So I am going to want to start from scratch and grab an app from the market. And I've really found that there's only kind of one or two apps I really want, and this project app is one of them. So I click on projects, I click on next, and it installs it, thanks for coming, in my workspace. So if I go back to that workspace now, there it is there under my projects on the left. I'm going to find, there's Andrea who's now joined, and I'm going to find the projects icon. This is where it gets interesting because now I can create my own projects. Fantastic. So I might create a project called website, which might be building a website. I pick a manager, that's probably me. I can put start and finish dates and all of this kind of other stuff, like I'm planning it or whatever else, and save it. Then I can come back and I can create another new project. Let's do that. And the next one might be, say, social media. You might get a sense now that we are in the business of web stuff and social media is part of that. Or maybe I do one more project, which could be, say, a YouTube channel. Now, right now, all I have is these projects and a manager for each one, which is kind of defining how I'm going to do all of this stuff. But if I go back one step, can you see this breadcrumb right here? I can list all of my projects at once. Yummy. And I can see this kind of box layout. What's neat is if I want to do other layouts, I hit switch layout and I can go to, for example, a table or, for example, a list like so, right? All of those are very helpful, or I can make it calendar based. What's cool about this is I can actually, because this is a database, I can change this. If I think, you know what, I really don't want goals and metrics, I hit modify template up here and I can just burn that, bang, click, X, gone, thanks for coming, right? Or let's say I wanted to add one of those progress ideas, right? So now what I can do is I can drag in a progress field and suddenly that's everywhere. Or maybe I want to do, I like having like priorities. So I pull their category field, call it priority, and then just give each option that I want. In this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When I hit done, all of my projects now inside this workspace have those options. So I can prioritize this one at 1 and give it a completion of, you know, 38%, right? Beautiful. And now, here in the front, I'm going to start to see that priority. There it is. Social media might be second, you know, rating, and it's 58% done. You're seeing how this works? Over here, the website might be a fourth rating, and it's nearly done, and so on. So now I've got my projects set up, which is absolutely gorgeous. How do I create specific tasks for different people? This is the beauty of this thing. If I click into my project, and then I click on T, which is stands for task, it's gonna automatically associate this task with that project. See that one there, YouTube channel. So I might have, you know, start making videos. And then all I have to do is assign it to a person. I'll assign it to my assistant because she loves doing that stuff. Give it a due date, next Monday, and I'm done. I've got a task which now lists down here. And what if I wanted a second task? You know, I don't know, edit videos. Again, I'm going to give that to my lovely assistant, Andrea, and a due date of next week, or maybe a custom date of, say, the week after that, and I'm away. Now, what's cool is if I'm not inside of that project, and now I've clicked myself right back out the front, if I'm at the very top of Podio, which you get to by clicking on that Podio button, you can see, right, now I've created, this is the activity stream, I've created some tasks, these are the recent items that I've played with, which happen to be projects. These are the people who are involved, me and my assistant, the apps that I've been using and so on. So what's cool here is if I click T, I can still create a task, but notice because I'm way back here, it's not associated with any project space. So if I run it to, for example, write a blog post and I associated that with myself, Tim, thank you. It's not associated with any project space. So I click on this and it lists all of my project spaces, right? Or if I want it to be associated with that YouTube one, I just type in the word you and it finds the project and it assigns it for me, which is fantastic. So we have found that this is an amazingly good way to organize all of our tasks and all of our projects and all of our workspaces. And we have a workspace for each different client. But here is the last thing. This tick box up here is my favorite friend. What it does is, and it's trying to give me info there, it lists out all of my tasks. See that? And that's my write a blog one. But where are the others? Well, this is the beauty. When I click on my delegated tasks, it groups them by staff member. So I could have Andrea, I could have all the other people in my team with 50 tasks, And when it comes to a team meeting, which we do every Monday, we can simply walk through this task list and see what everybody's up to. Now, the other cool thing about this, and that alone would be enough for me to be very happy, that alone would be enough for me to be very happy, is that you can actually do the work inside the task. For example, you can add comments and you can say, you know, I'm doing well, or how are you doing, or this is just a test, because right now she's probably confused, because that comment gets mailed to her inbox. So right now she's probably thinking, what is Tim doing? Why is he sending me all this rubbish? So that's where I could explain that. Or if I need to attach a file or a link, all of those things can live associated with the task, right? And then I've got all the tasks I've completed, none yet. But the moment we complete a task, you just click on the, there you go. And now it goes into my completed tasks, just mine, or completed tasks for everyone in the business. So one way or another, I find, and we find, Podio to be a phenomenally good way for us to organize our tasks, our projects, our workspaces, and do so in a way that we can manage all of the internal projects we have, all of the client projects we have, and we can even arrange access to the different workspaces to different people. So all the different workspaces have their own separate access too. It's a great system. I highly recommend it. It's at the heart of my business now. My business has more than doubled this year alone, and this is still coping with ease. So I do highly recommend Podio. Enjoy.